Textron debuted its production standard Scorpion light strike and ISR aircraft at the recent Dubai Airshow to show off its advantages to governments in the region. The composite airframe twin-engine jet is conceived to be more cost-effective to operate in its specific role than higher-tier combat aircraft that aren't expressly built for that purpose. For example, its Honeywell TFE731 turbofan engines are typically used on corporate jets. Acquisition cost is approximately $20 million, and direct operating costs amount to only some $3,000 per hour. Brett Pierson, a test pilot for Textron, explained the aircraft's value proposition.
So I think what we see in this airplane is it'll be a much closer match to the requirements for an ISR light attack than some of the airframes that nations are using right now to do that mission. Specifically, what you find is the cost to operate is extremely low. When we're on station doing ISR in an orbit that lets us maintain constant surveillance of a target in an altitude and a distance that lets us do it without that target knowing we're there, you can do that for 1,000 pounds an hour total, 500 pounds on each side. Anybody who could look at the fuel flow on any of the tactical jets that are out there being used for ISR, it'll show that that's like between a quarter and a fifth of what those other airplanes are using. So the cost per hour is significantly lower. So in that sense, it's extremely well suited. Also, the MX-15 on this airplane, that's an electro-optical infrared sensor and laser targeter, takes the video that the MX-15 generates and puts it on a high-definition display in the cockpit that gives you a better picture than any I've ever seen in any airplane I've flown for ISR, and gives you the ability to take that same image and port it offboard through a variety of commercial data links so that someone on the ground can see in HD, in real time, the exact same thing the pilot sees on his scope.
The Scorpion has been designed so that the Garmin G3000 avionics are independent from the weapon system, allowing for quick and easy customization of the ordnance delivery and ISR hardware to accommodate any customer's needs.
At the light attack experiment in Holloman Air Force Base, we demonstrated and successfully fired guided and unguided 2.75-inch rockets, 50-caliber machine guns, and 500-pound class laser-guided weapons, specifically the GBU-12. That system of the MX-15, the Scorpion helmet-mounted queuing system, and those weapons gives us the ability to demonstrate a pretty capable, pretty competent weapon system, but also to show a customer that we could do this, whatever else you might need, we could also do. The airplane still has 3 payload bays completely unused that leave 85 cubic feet of space and 22 kilowatts of unbudgeted power to be whatever a customer might want to be in those bays. Any changes that are made to that weapon system does not have to affect the core Scorpion airframe or the core Garmin avionics. So we can rapidly turn any changing desires that you have. We had a case in Holloman where a change was suggested by someone who flew the airplane, and we thought that really is a good idea. It was a change to the way the HOTAS worked. Because of that federated weapon system and mission system, we were able to execute that change, turn it, test it, install it, and the same pilot flew the same airplane again 2 weeks later, only now it worked completely differently and the way he desired it. And that's a change that anybody who's got experience in government procurement knows would have been at least a 2-year turnaround. Because of the very integrated nature of the systems that most nations are using right now.
During that demonstration at Holloman, the aircraft caught the attention of General Mike Holmes, head of Air Combat Command. The general said he was intrigued by the aircraft's modular design and ability to integrate with numerous sensors, and has suggested that the Air Force could call for an ISR-specific demonstration in the future.
For something that looks like a tactical fighter aircraft, it's been built with the system safety processes and the mechanical backups and depth of engineering as Textron's civilian aircraft, which means the availability, the operational availability of this airplane is higher than most operators of tactical fighters have ever seen. We went to Holloman, did 20 consecutive flights, 20 different sets of tasks, never missed a flight. We flew here from the U.S. We covered 9 nations in 6 days, did 10 demonstration flights in Saudi Arabia, and never missed a flight. And our entire maintenance contingent for this trip was 2 maintainers and a quality assurance rep. And all they've really done is put gas in the airplane, do some light maintenance to make sure everything's tidy for the next day. It just, you put gas in it and it flies. And having been in command of a fighter squadron, That wasn't always what I saw. This is a very reliable airframe, which is great because you've got the ability to operate away from that main hub base where most of us have gotten used to operating, and lets us operate much more autonomously than you could probably operate with a small detachment of high-end fighters. And again, as high-end fighters would be much better used doing a completely different mission than burning off their fatigue life, circling around a target, looking at things. When this airplane is point designed to look, circle around targets and look at things.
While the aircraft has seen interest from a variety of countries, it has yet to find its first paying customer. However, with surveillance and targeting needs evolving, and defense budgets shrinking around the world, perhaps it's only a matter of time.